The car behind me doesn't really need an introduction. You look at it, you know there's a snake somewhere, you know. It's one of those few supercars around the world that you look at it, you know it's angry, it's mean, it's fast. Yeah, it's a new Dodge Viper.
Well, we're really excited to have the Canadian debut of the 2013 SRT Viper. It's hand-built in our Connor Assembly Plant in Detroit, Michigan, the heart of the Motor City.
We're at 640 horse, 600 pound-feet of torque, so the torque-to-weight ratio is outstanding.
The car is about 100 pounds lighter than the outgoing model. And if you opt for the optional track pack, it adds some lightweight brakes, lighter tires, lighter rims, and that takes about another 57 pounds out of the car. It has an 8.4 liter V10 engine. It'll go from 0 to 60 in 3.5 seconds. It'll do the quarter mile in 11.5 seconds, and it has a top speed of over 330 kilometers an hour.
We've introduced a lot of new technology with this vehicle. We've introduced traction control and electronic stability control, so it broadens the audience a little bit.
But yet, if you want to release the beast, you can turn off the traction control, and it's still the brute force that it always had.
Unquestionably, on the street, who doesn't want a safer car? Why wouldn't you want something that can brake better, and if you do something silly, will get you out of trouble? The problem with the previous Vipers, any Viper, is you do something silly, it will bite you. That's why it's a snake.
I've driven some of the Vipers before, and that was one of the things that turned me off, was the fact that, I mean, you'd be driving in third gear and you'd be spinning everywhere, so being a little bit more civilized is, I think it's fantastic.
Kind of like the Corvette, I mean, things have to progress with the times. These cars are low volume cars, so, you know, you invest in styling and performance maybe, and certain other things are left aside. Now the Viper, like the new Corvette, is modern. Now, welcome to the 21st century. Everything is where it should be. The radio is not from a Dodge Neon from the mid-1990s.
Interior-wise, it has the creature comforts. The original cars, I don't know if you remember the first one, the only creature comfort was a radio. And you could barely hear it when you're running down the road. The sound system in this vehicle is outstanding.
It's an all-new luxury interior. Leather wrapped everything. The accent stitching throughout the car is all contrasting. It adds a nice look to the car. And the center console has an 8.4 inch touchscreen media center.
Something unique to the SRT lineup though is the SRT performance pages that are coupled with the 8.4 screen. So you can actually measure your performance times with the vehicle and see it on the screen.
So the base car starts at $99,995. You can opt up to the GTS for $119,995, and that gets you some more premium features inside the car, an upscale set of wheels, the two-mode suspension, and the four-mode traction control.
The design's fantastic. I think they've done a great job compared to what it used to be. I've been a fan of it since it first came out, and kind of fell off a bit in the middle, but I think it's totally redeemed with this one. Fantastic, yeah.
What Chrysler managed to do is stay very true to the original design, which blew everyone's mind. The car is low, it's fat, it's wide, it's just long enough. The proportions are perfect. The stance is beautiful. You get the 640 horsepower, 8.4 liter V10. You get 600 pound-feet of torque. You get the big brakes. It's rear-wheel drive. Yes, yes. It's worth the money, absolutely. If only because it's a status symbol, in fact. You bought a Viper, you got big cojones, you know? You wanted a real car, a man's car. It's worth 100 grand.
At one time, I had a director get upset with me because I kept smiling, and he told me I have to look serious while I'm driving the vehicle. And how do you do that when you have a beautiful car with all that power? It does nothing but bring a smile to your face.
And I guarantee any kid from a distance going down the road will still yell out, "There goes a Viper," with a big thumbs up. So yeah, it's everything it should be.